settlement refrigerated trash.
I've noticed that.
He doesn't have to.
Mr. President, do you think Dan Quayle will be damaged by being compared with John Kennedy?
No. I thought that remark was a cheap shot and unbecoming a senator of the United States.
Last night, Senator Quayle said that there's human rights in South Africa. Do you agree?
That there are what?
Human rights in South Africa. Do you agree?
Yes. I think we're sitting beside a man in whose country that is a major goal.
No, not a goal, but he said that there is human rights in South Africa.
Well, yes, but I mean you continue wherever you find. I think we've had problems right down to modern days in our own country of establishing.
Mr. President, you've said it was a cheap shot for Senator Benson to compare Senator Quayle unfavorably with JFK. Wasn't Senator Quayle leading with his chin a little bit when he made that comment?
No. The only comparison he was making was that he is being attacked, and I think unfairly, on a basis of his age and his experience in government. And he was pointing out that John Kennedy, who sought the highest office and won it, had actually less experience in government than he has, and they were the same age.
Right, please. Thank you.
Let's go, please.
Thank you.
please. Thank you.
Well, the other room, we were discussing a few things here, some that I believe belong at this table instead of just between us. Major regional problems in Africa, which the president is addressing as OAU chairman, and we certainly appreciate the constructive role that you're playing in resolving these conflicts. We are, as we mentioned in there, deeply concerned about the civil war in Angola, and I was pleased to see an opening on national reconciliation take place immediately after the president's visit there. And I know that you will continue your efforts in that line. And we touched also on the mediation efforts concerning the Western Sahara and your excellent relations with the parties involved. I think will be an important asset in bringing about an agreement. And the U.S. fully supports the diplomatic efforts, including those of the United States, or the United Nations, General Secretary. Your offer of Bamako as a site for possible meeting between President Habré and Gaddafi was a generous one, and we appreciate your efforts to mediate that dispute. I didn't respond there when we touched on that subject. We are concerned by revelations concerning Libya's chemical warfare capability. And we urge the African states to take vigorous public action to confront this threat to regional stability. And we are discussing with other countries in the world the idea of an international conference to once and for all put an end to the threat of chemical warfare, of poison gas. Well, before we get on with that, it seems as if I'm drifting away from one of the major problems that you presented. Our own budget situation is difficult, but we intend to give Mali the fullest possible economic support within the limitation of our resources. We encourage you to continue our economic reforms. And President, you've been talking and telling me of the northern, his the whole African problem with regard to the indebtedness of everything. That would help could be forthcoming. We would with those, and I think that was what I suggested. Maybe that was the subject we should